welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to solve the next problems in the exercise 1 of the chapter numbers. Okay. So the next question is question number 22. The question is, a basket contains 15 and half hundred of lemons. A basket contains 15 and half hundred of lemons. Another basket contains 1,500 of lemons. How many lemons, less or more, are in the first basket than the second one? So see here, in this problem, there are two baskets of lemon. There are two baskets of lemon. First basket and second basket. Okay, so see here, in the first basket, how many lemons are there in the first basket? See, a basket, this is the first basket, a basket contains 15 and half hundred of lemons. 15 and half hundred of lemons. 15 and half hundred of lemons means how many lemons see here? 15 and half hundred means 15 complete hundred. 15 complete hundred. You know 1500, how we write 1500? 15 and after 15 two zeros. As you know that 100 means after one there are two zeros, right? So 1500 means after 15 there are two zeros. So this is 1500 and half hundred. 1500 and half hundred. Now half hundred means how many? We have seen in previous lecture, half hundred means half of 100. When there is 100, its half is. Half means when we make two parts, in each part there will be 50-50, right? 50 plus 50, 100. So half hundred means 50. So 15 and half hundred of lemons means 1500 plus half hundred. Half hundred means 50. So total 1550. So in the first basket, there are 1550 lemons. Okay? Lemons. Then in second basket, see, in the second basket, another basket, this is second basket, another basket contains 1500 of lemons. Now this is very easy to understand or easy to write, 1500. So 1500 lemons in the second basket. So can you tell me now, in the first basket, the lemons are more than the second basket or less than the second basket? As there are 1550 lemons in the first basket and 1500 lemons in the second basket. So in which basket lemons are more? Yes, first basket. So in the first basket, lemons are more than the second basket, right? Now we have to find how much or how many lemons are more in the first basket than the second basket. And to find that, we need to subtract. We need to find difference between these two. Okay, so difference, when we'll find difference between the lemons in both the basket, at that time we will get how many lemons are more in the first basket. So let's find 0 minus 0, 0. 5 minus 0, 5. 5 minus 5, 0. And 1 minus 1, 0. So difference between the lemons in two basket is 50. That means what, you know, in the first basket, 50 lemons are more than the second basket. So 50 lemons are, here we have to write conclusion, 50 lemons are more in the first basket than the second basket. Understood? Then we'll move towards the next question, that is question number 23. See, I'm reading here, by how much is 9 and a half thousand less than 27 and a quarter thousand. So two numbers are there. Which two numbers are there? 9 and a half thousand. See? 9 and a half thousand means how much? See the, which way the number is given? 9 and a half thousand means 9 complete thousand. 9,000 and half thousand. Okay? So see, 9,000 and half thousand, how to write 9,000, complete 9,000. And again, in there is half thousand. Half thousand means half of thousand. As we have written here, half of 100, 50, 50. Half of thousand, if we divide 1,000 into exactly two equal parts, in each part there will be 500 and 500, right? So a half thousand means one half, that is 500. So here, 500. So we will get this number, 9 and a half thousand means 9,500. So we got this number 9,500. We will write it separately here. And the second number is 27 and a quarter thousand. Now 27 and a quarter thousand means 27 complete thousand. 27,000 means this way. 27,000. Okay. And a quarter thousand. A quarter thousand means quarter means what? One fourth, right? One fourth means when we divide thousand into four equal parts. And we have seen this. 1, 2, 3, and 4. When we divide thousand into four equal parts, each part will have 250, 250, 250, and 250. Correct. And we want a quarter means one quarter. This is there are four quarters in that. A quarter means 250. So 27 and a quarter thousand means 27,000 and plus a quarter thousand. A quarter means 250. So that will be added here. So 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 5, 5, 2, 7, and 2. So that is 27,250. Okay. Now, we have to find that by how much is 9 and a half thousand less than the 27 and a quarter thousand. Means this 9,500 is how much less than the 27,250. And whenever we have to find, compare the two numbers, we have to find by how much it is, some one number is less than other number or one number is more than other numbers, less or more we have to find. In that case, we have to do the subtraction of both the numbers. That means from bigger number, we have to subtract smaller number. So here bigger number is 27,250, right? From this, we will subtract 9,500. Okay. So when we will subtract 9,500 from 27,250, we will get by how much this 9,500 is less than the 27,250. So 0 minus 0, 0. 5 minus 0, 5. 2 minus 5, 2 minus 5. Yes, not possible. So from 7 we will take 1 borrow, 2 cut 2 right up. 7 will remain 6. Okay. Now 12 minus 5. 12 minus 5. Yes. 7. 6 minus 9. Again 6 minus 9 is not possible because 6 is less than 9. So we will take 1 borrow here and these 2 will remain 1. Now 16 minus 9. Yes. 7 and 1 as it is. Okay. Understood. So the difference between these two numbers is 17,750. That means what? That means what? So, by how much 9,500 is less than this? By 17,750. 9,500, we can say 9,500 is less than 27 and a quarter thousand. Understood this? See, one similar example I am giving here. What is meaning of this? If you don't understand, see, there are two numbers, 10 and 7. Okay. So, see, what we can say, by how much the 7 is less than 10? By how much the 7 is less than 10? So, what we can say, see, difference between 10 and 7 is 3. That means by 3, or 7 is less than 10 by 3. Okay, or by 3, 7 is less than 10. Same, this example is same like this. By 17,750, this 9,500 is less than the 27,250. Okay, pause this video, write in your notebook, and after this, we will see next questions. Let's go for the next question. Question number 27. Actually, we have seen question number 22 and 23 before, and there are question number 24, 25, 26, which are based on Roman numerals, and those are easy questions you can solve by yourself. You have learned Roman numerals in 4th standard till 50, right? And those three questions are based on the Roman numbers till 50. So, you can solve those questions as a homework, okay? We will see here question number 27. What is question number 27? Children were fallen in equal rows for mass drill. Children were fallen in equal rows for mass drill. The two middle children had serial numbers 22 and 23. There were 10 such rows. How many children were present in the school that day? See the question. Children were fallen in equal rows for mass drill. Mass drill means SPT, right? So for that, the lines of children, rows of children were made, and in each row, there were same number of children. In each row, there were same number of children, such 10 rows were there. How many rows were there? There were such 10 rows, or 10 such rows were there. So, we have to find total how many students were present that day in the school, okay? So, see how to find that. The two middle children had serial number 22 and 23. Suppose this is one row, I'll write here. Row means line, okay? So, this is one row. We don't know in one row or in each row how many students are there. We just know that there are 10 such rows and in each row there are equal number of students. For example, if there are 10 students in first row, second also 10, third also 10, and up till 10 also, 10 rows, there will be 10 students. Suppose, okay, so we have to find in each row how many students are present or how many students are fallen in each row. Now, what hint they have given? They have given, see here, the two middle children had serial number 22 and 23. So, if we'll talk about first row, the students who are, the children who are at the middle, in the middle, suppose this is middle, two middle students they have given. So, here the roll number of them is 22 and 23. 22 and 23. So, these are two middle, you know middle. What is meaning of middle? Middle means as these two children are at the middle, in the middle, that means before them and after them, there will be same number of students or children. Means what? Suppose there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 children. Then here, which is the middle one? Yes, this is fourth one is middle because before 4 there are 3 students and after 4 there are 3 students. That means 4 is the middle. If we'll take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 children. Then which is middle one? Or how many, which students are, or which number of students are middle one? See, as there are 8 children, we cannot get any one student at the middle. Because if you take 5, then before 5 there are 4 and after 5 there are 3. So, this 5 is not at middle, in the middle. But, if you take 4 and 5 together, so before 4 and 5, there are 3 students and after them there are 3 students. Understood? That means the 4th one and 5th one children are in the middle. Similarly here, the children whose roll number is 22 and 23, they are in the middle. That means before them, how many children were there? As this number is 22, serial number, this roll number is 22. So before them, there will be roll number 1 to 21, right? 21, 20 and till 1. That means before 22, there will be 21 students. As before 22, there are 21 students. That means after this, there will be 21 students. 21 students or children. You will write children here. So before them there are 21 children and after them there are 21 children. Understood this concept? Once again I repeat, see here. This roll number, these are two roll numbers. These are two children whose roll number is 22 and 23 and they are in the middle. That means before them there will be equal number of students and after them there will be equal number of students. So as this number is 22, this roll number is 22, that means before these there will be roll number 1 to 21. That means there will be 21 children before these two middle children. As before them there are 21 children, that means after them also there will be 21 children. Understood? So total children in first row, each row, total or children in each row will be, how many children will be in each row? This 21 plus this after 21 children which are before them, 21 children which are after them, plus how many plus? Yes, these two children. So total 21 plus 21, 42 and 2, 44 children. So there are 44 children in each row. Got it? Each row means one row. Such there are 10 rows. So children in 10 rows. How to find children in 10 rows? Children in one row are 44. So children in 10 rows will be 44 into 10. That is 440. This 10 just keep here and 44 ones are 44. So there are 440 total children present in the school that day. So there were 440 children present in the school that day. Understood? Let's move towards the next question. Question number 28. How many 3-digit numbers can be formed using the digit 3 and 2 any number of times? Write down the largest and the smallest of those. So see this question here, 2 digits they have given, 3 and 2. Okay. So using 3 and 2, we have to form 3-digit numbers, all the possible 3-digit numbers, and there is allowed to repeat the digits. We can repeat these 2 digits any number of times to form 3-digit numbers. So see how to form. First, what we'll do, we'll take 3 at the first. 3. As we are allowed to repeat the digits any number of times, so we'll repeat 3 first. 3, 3, 3. We want 3-digit numbers, okay? So we have repeated 3 times. So we have got 333. Now what we'll do? 3, 3, and for instead of last 3, we'll write 2. So 332, then 3. Now for this, instead of this 3, we'll write 2. And here we'll write 3. 323. Again, 3 and 2, 322. So see, with the 3 at hundreds place, we got 333, 332, 323, 322. Fine. Now we will take 2 at the hundred place. So 222, 223. Okay. Then 232 and 233. Understood. So using these two digits 3 and 2, there are how many numbers are possible? How many 3-digit numbers are possible? 8 3-digit numbers are possible. Okay. So total 8 numbers are possible. Can be made. Okay. Now in these 8 numbers, which is the greatest and which is the smallest or which is the largest number? And smallest number we have to write here. So the largest number is 333, right? And the smallest one is 222. Understood this question? Okay, pause the video and write this in your notebook. We'll see next question after this. Let's see the question number 29. The question number 29 is, a 4-digit number has all its digits even. The digit in the thousands place is 3 times that one in the units place. The remaining digits are equal and the difference between their place values is 720. Find the number. So in this question, we have to find the 4-digit number. We have to find the 4-digit number whose all digits are even. Now you know, even digits, we have 10 digits. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 and 9. Okay. So these are 10 digits. Out of these, which are even digits? You know, even digits means the or even numbers means the numbers which are divisible by 2 or the numbers which have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 at their units place. So these digit even digits in these means 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8. So I'll write here even digits. As this 4-digit number is made up of all even digits. So we have these two, these even digits 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8. Okay. So the first condition is that the number is made up of even digits. And the second condition is the digit in the thousands place is 3 times that one in the units place. So see here, I'll write here 4 boxes. So see, the digit, this is ones place, tens place, hundreds place and thousands place. So the digit in the thousands place is 3 times the digit in the ones place. So whichever digit will come at ones place, if we multiply that digit by 3, we will get the thousands place digits. So in these 5 digits, 5 even digits, which combination is possible for this? Let's see, if we take 0 at the ones place, then 0 multiplied by 3, will we get any number? 0 multiplied by 3, we will get 0 itself, right? 0 multiplied by 3 is 0, so we will not get that. If we take here 2, 2 multiplied by 3, what we are getting? 2 multiplied by 3, 2 3s are 6 we are getting, right? That means if we will take 2 at the ones place, then we will get 2 3s are 6 at the thousands place. Understood? See, since 2 into 3 is equal to 6, so 2 will come at ones place. And 6 will be at thousands place. Now see, the second next condition, the remaining digits are equal. So remaining means these 2 digits remain, tens place and hundreds place. So these digits are equal. So digit at the tens place and hundreds place are equals, and the difference between their place values is 720. So do you remember we have solved this kind of example before, that the 2 boxes occupy same number, same digit, and the difference between their place values is given. So how to find that digit? See, see here, at the digits are at tens place and hundreds place. So difference between their place value places. Difference between the places places means hundreds minus 100 minus 10, because those that digit will come at 110th place, right? So the difference between the places, that is 100 minus 10 is 90. And difference between the place value, difference between the place values. So the difference between the place values are given, 720. Okay, difference between the places we have found here first, and the difference between the place values is given, 720. So the digit is, the required digit is difference between the place values divided by difference between the places, that is 720 divided by 90. So if you cut this 0, 0, then 9 ones are 9, 9 8s are 72. So the digit is 8. Okay, so the which digit will come here? 8 and 8. That, so the expected number is, pause the video, write down this, then we will move towards the next question. Question number 30. 5, 7, 9 and 0 are the digits of a 4-digit number. Here also there is one 4-digit number. Okay, there is one 4-digit number. Having place values 50, 7000, 9 and 0 respectively, find the number. So the, these are digits 5, 7, 9 and 0. These are the digits of that 4-digit number, but how to arrange them, or how, which digit is at which place, that is given, that will be decided by it, by their place values. So the place value of 5, place value of 5 is 50. That means 50 means 5 tens, right? So 5 will come at tens place, 5 tens. Place value of 7. Place value of 7 is what? 7000. That means 7000s. Place value of 9. Place value of 9 is 9 itself. Only 9. 9 means 9 ones, right? And place value of 0 is 0. Place value of 0 is 0. Now see, out of this 4, we have got places of 3. 5 tens, 7 thousands, 9 ones. Place value of 0 is 0. So 0, if 0 is in any place, its place value is 0 only, okay? So out of these 4 places, which place remain here? Hundreds place, right? So 0 will come at hundreds place. So the expected number is 4-digit number is 1s, tens, hundreds and thousands. So how many 1s? 9 1s, tens, 5, hundreds, 0 and thousands, 7. So 7059 is the expected number. Understood? So today, in today's lecture, we have learned these 6 questions. Write those in the notebook and try to understand. If you are not able to understand, if you have any doubt about these 6 questions, you are free to ask. So till that, thank you and have a nice day.